Welcome, dear students of class 7. We'll today start with the poem If. Growing up is not easy, and as we face the challenges of life, we often look to older people for guidance. Here is a poem in which a narrator consoles his son on how to lead a good life. Let us read what he says. So the main summary of this poem is given in this particular lines. We young people know how to learn a lot from the older people, and we seek their guidance when we actually want to, you know, live life in a proper way. So here a father is giving advice to his son as to how he should live in order to get that feeling of, you know, how it is possible to live a fruitful and a good life. So we can see over here that the poem reads like this. When the father says to his son and advises him how to live a life in a proper way, and gives the counseling, that is the advice, we'll see what he says. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. So you can see in the two lines it says that when your head you have to keep, all about you are losing theirs, and others are losing their heads, but you should not, blaming it on you. They're blaming that you are the reason, and they make you feel down, but at that time you should not, you know, have control over your head. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, all people will doubt, but you have to trust. In the third line it says yourself. All men will trust when you do something that he will be able to do, no, I don't think, and all that. But it's you have to keep trust on yourself that yes, if I put this effort, you will definitely be able to do what you want. But make allowance of their doubting too. But pay heed to that allowance, or pay heed to their doubts. The doubts which are there in the mind of people, maybe you have to correct and keep a watch on that also. You should not ignore those doubting people and the doubts why they are putting that type of, you know, uncertainty about what you are doing. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet, don't look too good nor talk too wise. बहुत अच्छा भी नहीं दिखाना है अपने आप को और बहुत ही वाइज भी नहीं दिखाना है. और बी हेटेड, डोंट गिव वे टू हेटिंग. हेटेड, कोई आपसे नफरत करे तो आप भी उसे नफरत का सिला मत दे. और बीइंग लाइड अबाउट, डोंट डील इन लाइज. आपके आगे पीछे सब लाइज बोलते हैं, तो आपको लाइज बोलना ज़रूरी नहीं है. आपको झूठ बोल के अपना जो है कैरेक्टर को बोल सकते हैं ढीला नहीं करना है, राइट? वी डू दीज थिंग्स लाइक लाइज एंड ऑल दैट, यू विल बी कंसिडर्ड नॉट अ गुड कैरेक्टर. दैट इज़ वाई. इफ़ यू कैन ड्रीम एंड नॉट मेक ड्रीम्स योर मास्टर, इफ़ यू कैन थिंक एंड नॉट मेक थॉट्स योर एम, इफ़ यू कैन मीट विथ ट्रायम्फ एंड डिजास्टर एंड ट्रीट दोज टू इम्पोस्टर्स जस्ट द सेम. सो ट्रायम्फ एंड डिजास्टर, लूजिंग एंड विनिंग, happiness and, you know, the feeling of depression, all these are, you know, the thoughts of a mind. And if you can dream and not make dreams, that means either you are triumphant or a disaster, so that will strike you. And treat those two imposters just the same, you know, if you lose or win, treat them as same. If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves, and make a trap for fools. Or watch the things you gave your life to, broken, and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. You know, these type of knaves, what do you say, twisted by knaves. Knaves are those people who are not good enough in their skills to make trap for fools. You know, these knaves, they don't know anything, and they want to make trap for fools. Or watch the things you gave your life to broken, you know, on और वॉच द थिंग्स यू गेव योर लाइफ, यू नो अपनी जिंदगी में क्या जिंदगी को क्या दिया है, ब्रोकन इन स्टूप एंड बिल्ड देम अप विथ अ व्हाट यू कॉल इट द वॉर्म स्टूप एंड worn out tools means tools which are not which are too much used then of no what do you call it, effectiveness has not remained that much that it should be, that's worn out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn or pitch and toss and lose and start again at your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss. So life is about risk. If you have so many winnings with you and the rise, the risk is there in that when you want to pitch and toss or do things, keeping that winnings into your efforts to get something else, to start again, and so at that time also you lose, then keep your heart and you know, the start from beginning. Okay, I lost everything, I'll start from the beginning and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinews, you can see our names are dishonest people, sinews are strong, you know, band of issue that you know joins the muscle to bone, sinews, you know, it's a scientific term, source of strength and power. So here you can see that strength and power which you have, that along with your heart, try to get the loss done, to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. So here, you know, everything is lost, everything is gone at that time, hold on, keep it on, what you are doing, keep it on, and have that perseverance. Perseverance means if all the things are happening around you, then also you work on it and try to make things that are really, you know, in your view, it has some difficulties to attain, but you have to keep your that going. So with this page, we'll move to the next page where we'll see how the last paragraph fares, or how the last paragraph is viewed or given by the writer, as he, you know, this small child is counseled by the father. So moving further with this, you know, father on a sitting on a bench in a park or a garden, and then helping out his son to, you know, understand what is life. So here we can see that, you know, he further advises and counsels that if you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, not lose the common touch. Walk with the highest people, the kings, but you don't lose the common touch, the touch which you are original. Don't try to, you know, wear a clock of, you know, you are a very big person. Just like, you know, by getting the feathers of different birds, a bird try to get very beautiful. You got the feathers of peacock, you don't become a peacock. That is the counseling or the thing that is, you know, advice by the father. If neither foreign nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth, the everyone, everything that is in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son. So you follow this advice and, you know, count on, you know, feel the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run. You know, unforgiving minute is there and you have that fault, but, you know, unforgiving, you cannot forgive that misdeed of yours or something. Only 60 seconds worth of, you know, jogging your mind. Yours is the earth. So if you gather the solution, you will get it then. And yours will be the whole earth is in within you. And everything that's in it also, what is in it will be yours. And which is more, you will be a man, my son. So you have followed this particular advice of winning, losing, and maintaining a cool composure, how to intervene with other people and how to discuss about them, and yet, you know, not to stay that very disturbed all the time, or you feel very down at that time, what to do. All these things are very nicely counseled by this father to his son, and that way, you know, the son gets the counseling which helps him. He says further that by heeding to my these things which I have told you, you will be a man. You will, which is more, you will be a man. Everything, it's in it, you know. Earth will be yours and you will get everything. You will be a man, my son. So you will become a man, you know. Man in the sense, a true person who is civilized and a good person called by the society. But that will be the benefit you will get if you follow the advice or counseling which I am giving you, that the father says to the son. So, a very inspiring poem by Rudyard Kipling. You know, can say here that Rudyard Kipling was a noted British writer of prose and verse. Prose and verse. Prose means, you know, the story part, and verse means the these poems and these long verses that we see. Born in Mumbai, India. He went to England at the age of 5 for education as well as for popular collection of short stories. You know, he, among the well-known are his Barrack Room Ballad, Rewards of the Fairies, as well as the popular collection of short stories called The Jungle Book in 1907. He was, you know, awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature. So, very important prize of a Nobel Prize he was given because of his contribution to literature. And with this, you complete the if poem. The prose, the part of question answers, we can say the making connections and other, in a post this poem, which is given in the textbook, that I'll be giving to you in the next lecture. Till then, see you and goodbye.